Because one thing I did in my meetings, I told parents, I'm not putting up with crap. You ain't gonna talk to me about money, guys. They didn't have that conversation last 10 seconds, and they're busting down the door. We didn't have issues. The reason why we didn't have issues, or let me explain this, the reason why we won, is we didn't have issues. My parents let me coach. What they did. Because they let me coach, my kids let me coach them. And because of that, we won. And we won a lot. I also know how hard it is to be a parent. So I want to share something with you about that night before this day in school and my son's high school career. We were practicing at the Chamber of Arts, which would be the last practice that my son would ever practice, and to be honest with you, it's the last practice that I coached at the high school coach in South Dakota. But when my son was done, I decided to hang out and go pick over and run the country. That night, after the worst basketball practice that we had in 17 years of New York high school basketball, our kids weren't focused, they didn't do things right. And I knew as a head coach, I was not going to be prepared, or my team wasn't going to be prepared to play Xavier Norris and the boys in the field. So on the way home, me, still trying to be a coach instead of a dad, I spent 5 minutes chewing my son's butt like no other. Like no other. My son is a tough kid. I see my son cry 3 times in his life. 2 of them revolve to death. The third time I'm about to take him on the driveway. My son started to cry so uncontrollably, guys, he could barely breathe. You ever seen somebody hyperventilate before? To the point you don't know if they're going to catch that next breath? So I'm looking over my son Skylar, and I said, Skylar, what the hell's wrong with you, man? Get your stuff together. What the hell are you praying for? You're better than that. You're tougher than that. I'm trying to still be a coach, and not a dad. And after about 2 minutes, guys, when he could finally muster up enough strength to talk, he looked me square in the eye. And when a 17-year-old boy became a man, he said, and he said, Dad, I don't care about the 1,000 points I scored, or the 2 state tournaments I played in, or even all state, I don't care about it. The only thing that I want is I want you to be proud. Parents, your kids don't want you to be a coach. Your kids want you to be a mom and a dad. Your kids want you to be proud of them. Your kids want you to support them. They don't want to walk off the court when they're done playing. And after Lance has chewed his butt, or after Jesse's chewed his butt, but not doing what they're supposed to be doing, and then hear it from you all over again. They don't want it. Parents, I'm going to give you 3 pieces of advice. There's only 3 things you should ever say to your kid after your game. Only 3. And I learned this the hard way. And it's the other reason why I took 5 years out of my head. I ran the pedagogy, I'm not saying this, but I'm not on that sideline at the moment. But I was not going to be a coach to my God. I was going to be there. The 3 things you tell your kids after a game. Number 1, I'm proud of you. Number 2, I love you. Number 3, what do you want to be? And I'm kidding, I'm going to do it. And then I'm going to challenge you not to talk about the game. Talk about it the next day. It's okay to talk about the game with your kids, but not right after the game. Because when we win, what do? We feel great. And our kids feel great. And it's time when we win, we don't play that good. And what happens when we lose? We're upset. We say things we can't think that, but the most difficult, most powerful thing in the world is words. And the guy's words can be great, and they can also be broken. And you can't take back what you said. So be very careful, parents, what you say when you're around the kids. I'm going to honestly tell you, as parents and as athletes, I'm going to give you the key to success. And it's not something I read in the book, it's not something I watched on a movie. It's 17 years of trial and hard work. The most important component of your key to success is not your hope. It's not your hope. We get way too much credit from the men, and we take way too big of a beating on them. There's three different areas that has to happen for us to be successful. We have to have all the assets.